This is Wellness Wednesday, brought to you in part by Intermountain Healthcare.
We have all heard the desperate need for personal protective gear during the COVID-19 pandemic. In today's Wellness Wednesday, right now, there is an effort underway to ensure Utah has enough face masks for everyone on the front lines.
It's being called the largest Utah-based volunteer effort since the 2002 Olympic Winter Games.
Project Protect is a collaboration between Intermountain Healthcare, the University of Utah Health, and Latter-day Saint Charities.
Thousands of Utah volunteers putting their sewing skills to work to make face masks for frontline caregivers fighting COVID-19.
We're trying to produce 5 million medical-grade masks in a five-week period of time.
A big goal, according to Dan Lilienquist, Chief Strategy Officer with Intermountain Healthcare.
This is a project that really spans the entire community.
But a challenge being accepted by people throughout the state.
There are, literally tens of thousands of people who have taken up the challenge.
One of the mask seamstresses, Gail Miller.
It's such an enlightening project for me, and I'm just really pleased to be a part of it. It's exciting for me to have a little bit of a hand in helping the healthcare.
Like all volunteers, Gail picked up instructions and material from organized, contactless Project Protect distribution events, and then assigned a day to drop off the completed masks.
I have been able to facilitate about 2,000 masks.
Masks that will be a critical component to someone, somewhere.
I'm going to be very careful. So this gives me an opportunity to do service and feel useful.
And in its own way, Project Protect bringing people together, even while the pandemic keeps us apart.
We're just profoundly grateful for all of the individuals who have stepped up to donate their time and their talents to help us fill this critical need for our community.
Really is a great program. And Gail Miller, 2,000 masks. Wow, job well done. If you would like to learn how you can volunteer to make those masks, there are still a couple weeks left, and we do have more information on our website. Find it at fox13now.com.